guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adeze and I'm a YouTuber based in Port Harcourt, Nigeria. If you're a returning subscriber, you're welcome back. And if you're a new subscriber, thank you so much for clicking on this video. Please join the family by clicking the subscribe button and also turning on the notification bell so that you're notified anytime I post a new video. So how do I look, guys? Do you like the way I look? Yeah, so in this video I'm going to be showing you all about this hair. This hair is from Unice Hair. I've had this hair for a while and I've used it a lot. Anyway, I filmed a video about this hair when I just unboxed it, where a professional helped me to lay my wig. A professional did not lay it again for me this time. I did it myself. I hope I tried. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the 5 friends I got rid of this year. Like, this year I was brutal. I told myself, these 5 friends of mine, you guys have got to go, okay? You have got to go. You have no place in my life. I'm moving on from you. Because to be honest, you need to learn to walk away from some friendships, okay? Because some friendships are really toxic for you, okay? So if you'd like to know the 5 friends I walked away from this year, I don't know why I'm popping my neck and all that. So if you'd like to know the 5 friends I got rid of this year, and like to know more about this, my hair, just keep on watching. So today is my children's Christmas party and I'm getting ready to go for it. So today's video is sponsored by Unice Hair. I've had them on my channel several times. So Unice Hair is a company based in China. They have their store on AliExpress and you can get nice hairs from them. So this is the hair. If you guys watched my last Unice Hair video, they gave me their Brazilian hair in 24 inches. So that's the hair. Yeah, that video where I had a professional slay my hair. So I just curled it yesterday so that I can wear it with curls. I don't want tight curls, but I wanted to have curls. That's why I curled this with bendy rollers. Yeah, I just curled it with bendy rollers. I can't wait to see what it will look like, but I'm sure it's going to be very beautiful. If you need affordable hair that is very beautiful, just go and check them out. All their links are going to be in the description box. And yeah, so let's just get on with the video. I'm already late actually for this event because it's not yet time, but considering that I want to do hair and makeup, I'm already late. So let me just remove the bendy rollers and put the hair on my head. Ahead and do my makeup while we chat. I'm using my primer, my Pond's primer. You guys, I'm not a makeup artist, so I might not call some of the things that I use because there's really nothing to it, but anyone I remember I'll call. So I'm using the Pond's primer. I already have my sunscreen and my moisturizer on. So as the year is coming to an end, this is the time of the year when most people start taking stock of their lives, and I was also taking stock of my life, like how my life has been this year, things that I've done this year, things that I achieved, things that I did not achieve. And while trying to take stock, I realized that the first thing I started going to was the negatives. I didn't do this, I didn't do this, I was supposed to do that, I was supposed to make this progress, I was supposed to reach this milestone. You know, that was the first thing my mind went to when I started thinking about this topic. But I don't have to tell myself, girl, calm down, okay? There's some things that I did not achieve, but there are many things that I also achieved. Even things that were not on my vision board, I achieved them while they were not on my vision board, that even became worse anyway. So it's what it is, but I told myself I won't go straight to the negatives. But at the same time, I would like to talk about some of the toxic friendships, that I got rid of this year, or at least that I tried to get rid of this year, and I'm sure that by next year I'm totally going to get rid of them. If you've been on my channel for a while, I'm sure you'll be familiar with some of these things I want to talk about. Some of these friends I've featured some of these friends on my channel before, so yeah if you're on my channel, I'm sure you will understand what I'm talking about, okay? So before I go ahead and talk about the friends, I want to talk about the fact that me and these friends have been together for so long. Like for some of them, for almost all my life, I've known these friends. And this year, I just told myself, you know what? That's it. We're done with knowing each other. I think I need to move on. Like I need to get rid of these friends. So I'm using the Kiko Universal Fit Foundation. To be honest, I don't know if that's my color or not, but oh joy. So yeah, some of these friends, I've known them all my life. They've played different roles in so many things I've done in my life. They've been holding me back for so long, so long, guys. So yeah, the first friend is the unforgiving friend. Now, these things I'm calling friends are actually toxic traits that I have, okay? So if you are here for some tea, if you are here thinking that I want to come and start ratting out people, you are wrong. These my so-called friends are toxic traits that I have, and I have to recognize that I have these traits. I just have to recognize that I have these traits. A lot of us, because we don't see ourselves, we are very quick to point out issues that other people have and forget that we ourselves were not perfect, okay? We are not perfect. Some of you in your relationships, you are the problem in your relationships, but you won't accept it because you've refused to tell yourself the truth, okay? So this is the moment of truth for me. This moment for truth for me. Well, I've had this moment of truth for a very long time, but yeah, I'm sharing it with you guys so that if you are out there, you can relate. Also tell yourself the truth. Let us evolve and get better. I keep saying it, I'm all about evolution. Especially next year, 2020. 2020 is like the end of another era or beginning of another era. Anyway, end or beginning, whatever. So I am not going to enter next year with some of these traits. Now, the first one, like I said, is the unforgiving friend. And you know the irony of it all? The irony is that I'm very quick at forgiving people. I'm very quick at forgiving others. If you ask some of my friends think that I'm stupid, or not that I'm stupid, some of my friends think that I'm too naive, or I don't know how to explain it, but some of my friends might think that I forgive people easily, even when I shouldn't be forgiving them. Even when people are the ones that clearly hurt me, I usually forgive them easily because I just feel, the truth is that I like to make excuses for people. I like to understand where people are coming from. So I might not agree with you, what you are doing might be hurtful to me, but I kind of get it. I try to psychoanalyze people sometimes. So if I psychoanalyze you and I see that, okay, this thing is something that you don't even know that you have, it's just a problem that you need to deal with, I'm using the LA Girl Pro Concealer in fun. So I might not be so quick to discard you or to cancel you. Yeah, I'm not quick to cancel people, but I'm quick to forgive people and just be like, what person did to me is hurtful, but at the same time, I really don't blame this person. Or I try to look for good things about the person and say, well, even if this person is mean, at least the person is this, or at least the person is that. So that's what I do for other people. But for myself, nah, I find it hard to forgive myself. There are some things that I will do that, in fact, things I did years ago that even till today, for me to forgive myself, if I remember them, I'm like, why was I so stupid? Like, it keeps me back. Like, it seriously keeps me back from achieving some things because I feel like, what is wrong with me? Something is wrong with me. Why can't I just do better? Why did I make such mistake? You know? But this year, I have to tell myself, girl, you have to learn to forgive yourself, okay? I know a lot of people that are like that. That same forgiveness that you are quick to give others, also give it to yourself. Be accountable for your actions. Hold yourself responsible for your actions, but also move on from them. Don't let it hold you back. So now, I have two friends that I got rid of this year, and I'm making sure that friend stays away, is the fearful friend. You guys, I'm someone that fear of failure holds back a lot. Like, fear of failure, fear of what if it doesn't work, what if I'm not good enough. That part of me that allows fear to paralyze me is the friend that I did away with this year. Like, if you guys know how hard it was for me to actually turn on the camera and start filming, even shyness, being shy to an extent, part of being shy is also a fear of failure, I think. I'm not sure, but I think that's like a fear of failure. The fear is paralyzing sometimes because instead of me to take action, I'll just be like, hey, what if it doesn't work? Or what if it doesn't work? That's how I'll be doing what if it doesn't work. And then I'll not now try that thing again. I'll not now do it again. Because in my mind, I'm like, what if it doesn't work? What if it doesn't work? Until one day I have to sit down and ask myself, this thing that what is the worst that can happen? I keep saying this thing, and that's the truth. What is the worst that can happen if you take the next step? Highest things will not work out. You move on. Will anybody come and put a gun to your head? Why didn't it work out? Ah, you're going to die now because if it didn't work out. Nothing will happen to you if you try that business, that job, try that, whatever it is you want to try, that, shoot your shots, okay? What is the worst that can happen if you shoot your shots? Why are some of us scared of shooting our shots, even in relationships, even with friendships? Why are we scared of shooting our shots with jobs, with opportunities? There's nothing wrong with failing. Even the richest people in the world, the most successful people in the world, the most phenomenal people in the world have at one point in their lives failed. Some of them failed miserably. Like, they failed, but they got up and they moved on and they became the best at whatever they put their hands to. Yeah, so the next friend that I got rid of this year, and I pray she doesn't come back because she's a very stupid friend, is the what would people think friend, okay? What would people think? See, hey, God of mercy. If you are like me and that fear of what would people think is stopping you from doing anything, just get rid of it, okay? It does not help. It does not help. Shyness. I got rid of shyness this year. Shyness does not help anybody. Yes, shyness will help you. Like I keep saying, shyness will help you not to act a fool in public. Sometimes, yes, shyness will help you not to be stupid in public because you'll be even too shy to try something. So yeah, your chances of you being stupid in public is less with shyness. Okay? But at the same time, shyness keeps you from achieving a whole lot. I see a lot of people who say they want to start a YouTube channel, but they are so scared because of they don't really, you know, they are shy. How people see them? You better stop it. You better get rid of that because it is just keeping you back from achieving what you can achieve in this life. Okay? And you know the funny thing, people don't really care. People don't care as much as you think. Even trolls, when you see people that come and troll other people, you see people that go online and bash other people, see, they don't really care. Most of them are just jobless. Some of them, they are just scrolling bored with their lonely lives, scrolling, and they saw your page and they're like, let me just tell this person something stupid and move on. They don't even think about you after they've let that comment and gone sometimes. So, if you're the kind of person that trolls get to you, or what people think is getting to you, you better stop it because you're not helping yourself. You're not helping yourself at all. And you know the funny thing, people are also scared of what you think about them. That's just the fact of life. So why are we all scared? Do what you want to do, have your fun, and just move on, okay? The world will adjust. People will adjust. Once people see that you're living your best life, okay? That term is actually funny, but yeah. Once people see that you are living your best life, you don't really care what they think, what they are saying to you does not get to you, they will move on. They will move on to the next insecure person. They'll move on to the next shy person. Move on to the next afraid person. Okay, right now I really don't care what people think again as much. Not that I don't care totally. I still care, but not as much as I used to. It's certainly not stopping me from doing what I want to do. Some of you have a business, but because your business is not what you think you should be doing at this time in your life, you don't want to sell your business. Don't talk about your business. You are just doing yourself. Okay, so the next friend I got rid of, well, not totally, but we're still getting there, is the self-deprecating friend. So I have this self-deprecating humor. I don't have a problem yabbing myself, taking jabs at myself, joking about some things about myself. So it's something I do without really batting an eyelid at, like, I'm just making jokes at myself. I'm just poking fun at myself. You might see it as, it's not just humor. It's all in good fun. No, it's not. It's not all in good fun. You are actually affecting your self-esteem without knowing it. That's one. And then two, you are using your mouth to manifest the wrong things about yourself. Okay? You're using your mouth to manifest the wrong things about yourself. And you are now bringing people's attention to the wrong things about yourself. Even things they don't notice or they don't care about, you are using your mouth to point it out so that people will not notice it. Okay? So yeah, to me, I feel it's even a symptom of low self-esteem when you're a kind of person that makes self-deprecating jokes a lot. Talking down at yourself, joking about yourself, taking jabs at yourself. You need to stop it if you're that kind of person, okay? Speak only positive things about yourself. Speak uplifting things about yourself. Speak amazing things about yourself. I now move the humor to a positive kind of humor. So I might say things like, oh my god, I'm so awesome. Not because I feel like I'm more awesome than anybody out there, or that I'm seeing myself more highly than I should. That's not it. It is just my own way of uplifting myself. If I don't uplift myself, who will? If I don't say positive things about myself, because who am I expecting to say it about me? You know, so yeah. So now the last friend that I got rid of, or I tried to get rid of, is the social justice warrior, okay? The social justice warrior. If you don't know what a social justice warrior is, it's someone who basically fights for social justice, but the person is just doing it for selfish reasons, just for attention's sake. Some of them don't have deep convictions. Some of them don't even believe what they are saying, but because it's the in thing to say, it's the cool thing to say, they say it. You know, because everybody's thinking this way, you feel like you have to think that same way because that is the trendy way to think, right? So now, I think long and hard before I take a stand on anything, I think long and hard about it, like, why am I taking this stand? Why am I taking this position? Does it really make sense to me? Does it really make, like, if I analyze things critically, does it really make sense to me? I've also learned to listen to opposition, really listen to opposition to understand them. I may not agree with you, but I like to listen. Like, I know that in some of the collabs that I did, people observed that I wasn't talking as much as other people in the video. And that's because I have learned, it's not just last this year anyway, over time, I've learned to listen more than I speak, especially when I'm with people. Like, I'm the kind of person that can stay with you. I'm talking about your life, I'll just be soaking it up. I'll just be understanding, I'll just be listening to you and be trying to understand you, who you are as a person, why you do what you do, why you make the decisions that you make. I've realized that people cannot all think the same way. People cannot all have the same opinion about things. A lot of things inform why we are the way we are. And your own is not better than my own. My own is better than your own, except when it comes to clear-cut thing, right and wrong, or clear-cut sin. Every other thing is just how God made us. It's just based on personality differences. So I don't look down on other people for the choices they make with their lives, because you are doing things differently. That you are doing things differently from me does not mean that you are wrong. Okay. So yeah, and then another thing I even got rid of too, still related to social justice warrior kind of, is if I have a close friend and someone does something to the close friend, I immediately take it up. I used to buy cases for people. Like, I used to buy kids, like, you just tell me, ah, the person did this thing to you. In my mind, that person is done. I'm done with that person. Even if the person not do anything to me personally, my dear, I have moved on from that, eh? I will not, like, now when I have a friend that someone did something wrong to, I will not go out of my way to flaunt my friendship with the person that's wronged you, okay? I won't flaunt that friendship to you. I will not talk about the person with you. I might even not bring up a person as a topic whenever we are together, but that does not mean that I will not cancel the person or become or hate the person, because I was not there when people were having the issues that you were having. So why should I be taking sides without really understanding this person's side? Okay, so yeah, because of loyalty, I was that way before because of loyalty, but right now loyalty is not just blind. My loyalty is not blind, okay? I'm loyal to my friends in the sense that I'll be able to understand the truth, tell them the truth when I need to tell them the truth, and if they don't accept it, I move on. But it's not going to affect the way I treat other people. Okay, so if you're like me, that once they do anything to your friend, they didn't do it to you, you will go there and start fighting. It's not worth it. That's actually childish behavior. It's really not worth it. I'm not saying you should go out of your way to become friends with your friend's enemy. Don't go out of your way and say, ah, no, yeah, she didn't do it to me, let me now go and become her friend. No. But if you guys are already friends, if you guys are already close, if you guys already had a relationship, just because that person did something to another friend of yours doesn't mean that you have to, except it's something outrightly outrageous or something really, really terrible that even you too, you can't even stomach it. Uh-huh. But when it's just normal conflicts, normal friendship issues, just step back. Advise both parties if you want to, but step back, okay? It's none of your business. Yes, mind your business, drink your water, and you'll be fine, okay?
Yeah.
So let me go and put on my outfit and I'll be right back. This year, I've actually grown a lot. This year, I now do things with conviction. I don't just do things because it's a trendy thing to do. I don't take ideologies because, oh, it's trendy to think this way, trendy to say this. That is why I have opposing opinions on some things, like on feminism, on cancel culture, and some other things. I'm not the person that wants to shove my own opinion down your throat, okay? So as much as I don't think, as much as I think differently, I will let you think the way you want to think, because for me, we are all in different spaces in our lives. Maybe at some point you get to where I am, or I might get to where you are, or whatever, or we might never get to where each other is, but I allow people to think the way they want to think. I can just tell you my opinion, but I won't look down on you or shove it down your throat or try to make it look like you are, there's something wrong with you for thinking the way you think, okay? Because like I said, I've realized that human beings are different. Yeah, we can't all think the same way, because if not, this life would be so freaking boring. So how did I do, guys? This is the final look. I think I look beautiful. I think I look beautiful, Sha. I'm already late though. Yeah, like I said, I got this hair from Unice Hair. Check for their links in the description box so that you can get this hair. And yeah, so that's it for this video. And I also like to know your thoughts about everything I just said. Do you agree with me? Do you not agree with me? Why do you not agree with me? Do you at least understand where I'm coming from before you disagree with me? Yeah, so yeah, I'd like to see your comments in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, please. And yeah, I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.